I prefer to fight people from outside of North America, just because I find that that's when you get really recognized. You have to have a game plan for every fighter. I'm preparing for Sitman Chai to beat him and move into the final. Different styles make great matchups. He's going to be pushing forward with his Thai pace, you know, single shots, hard, powerful. I'm going to be throwing combinations. It'll definitely be more a Western style versus Thai.
A spot in Glory's Featherweight Championship Tournament later this year is on the line. Glory 17, LA! The Featherweight Contender Tournament semifinal number one, Duke Yodkumpan, Sitman Chai, and Gabriel Varga, two very athletic featherweights.
Well, the old classic East versus West. Years ago when I got into kickboxing, the rival was Thailand versus Europe and then the world. And that's what we're going to see tonight, that difference in styles.
Two highly ranked fighters.
First to make his way to the glory ring, he is a second degree karate black belt who began his martial arts training at the age of five. Please welcome Gabriel Varga.
Year-old Gabriel Varga from Canada enters into this fight with a 2-1 record in Glory, ranked number 5 in the featherweight division.
Yeah, I like this kid a lot. He's very well-rounded, a lifelong martial artist, and he throws a lot of cool moves in the ring. Definitely, I think what it's going to throw Sitman Chai off is his speed, his movement, and his ability to spin.
Varga is the favorite to win the tournament, mostly due to his pro experience.
Counted among the famed Lupini Stadium's top 10 for his Muay Thai talents, he is Yodkumpan Sitman Chai.
A highly praised fighter in Muay Thai, Yodkumpan Sitman Chai from Thailand, comes in with a 1-0 record, ranked number 3 in the Glory featherweight division. A lot of people are extremely excited to see what Sitman Chai can do in the world of Glory kickboxing.
He had a good debut, but you can tell he had a hard time adjusting to the kickboxing. But he said in the fighters meeting with his team that he's been training a lot with non-Thai fighters that are visiting Sitman Chai in Thailand, and he's really been working on his kickboxing style. He's such a young talent. If he could pick it up, he's 19 years old with 107 fights. A lot of experience at such a young age.
Semi-final number 1 in the featherweight contender tournament, Yodkumpan Sitman Chai facing off against Gabriel Varga. Duke, break down the tale of the tape.
Well, Varga is 10 years older, but the key here, I believe, is he's got to use his height and reach not to get in there and mess with this Thai guy's power shots and knees.
Here are the Glory rules. Each bout is scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds with the potential of a sudden victory round if the bout is scored a draw. Glory World title fights are 5 3-minute rounds. Three judges score the bout using the 10-point must scoring system and based on knockdowns, impact on opponent, and scoring with spectacular technique. Glory's maximum knockdown rules are if a fighter suffers 3 knockdowns in a round or 4 within a fight, the bout will end by way of TKO or knockout. For tournament matches other than the finals, 2 knockdowns in a round and 3 in the fight terminates the match. No elbow strikes, takedowns, or submission attempts are allowed, and the fighters can only clinch if they attack immediately with knee strikes. Now for the official introductions, here's the international voice of Glory, Tim Hughes.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contender tournament semifinal scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds. Introducing first, fighting out of the black corner, he is the WKF, WKN world champion, undefeated as an amateur. His professional career, 23 wins with just 2 losses. Standing 5 feet 10 inches tall, 1.78 meters. He weighed in at 142.5 pounds, 64.7 kilograms. Fighting tonight out of Toronto, Canada, and ranked number 5 in the world. Introducing Gabriel Varga. His opponent, fighting from the white corner, has defeated some of the biggest names in Muay Thai. His professional record, an amazing 83 wins, 21 losses, 1 bout scored even, 51 wins by knockout. At 5 feet 8 inches tall, 1.73 meters, he weighed in at an even 144 pounds, 65.2 kilos, fighting out of Thailand and ranked number 3 in the world. Please welcome Yokun Pan, Moo Sit Mo. Your referee for this matchup is Dej Sriampai.
Run Kruk and Duke Rufus ringside for Glory 17 Los Angeles. What an electric atmosphere here as we are set to kick off semifinal number 1 of the featherweight contender tournament. This is going to be exciting. Now remember, in a Glory tournament semifinal, 2 knockdowns and around 3 in a bout will equal a TKO or knockout. Yokun Pan Sitmunchai in the white gloves and Gabriel Varga in the black gloves and black shorts. Varga goes low with a low kick, but doesn't land.
Well, it's going to be interesting to see what he does. Is he going to go fast because we're in a tournament, or is he going to try and pick him apart from the outside, meaning Varga?
Sitmunchai loves to throw those stinging front kicks. Still learning, though. You know, you mentioned in his debut, he was very hesitant. He didn't know he could warm up, so he came out and he was very cold. We'll see if Sitmunchai picks up the pace here early.
You know, different in Thailand, they fight at a lot of the same venues all the time, where a lot of the Western fighters are constantly switching venues. It's a little different when the Thai fighters come over here. It's a completely different atmosphere for them.
Well, Sitmunchai said he was a little starstruck, making his debut on the big stage of Glory at Glory 15 Istanbul, but he did get the win over Raz Sarkisian. This guy, 83-21-1 record for Sitmunchai. As many of the Thais in their experience, you could probably double that number of fights, Duke.
Yeah, it's a fighting culture. They grew up as kids fighting, but you know what? Vargas, he's the same way. He grew up in a family of martial artists, so he's been competing since he was a small boy at various martial arts.
Sitmunchai got that uppercut through.
Stop. Well,
I think California did a really smart thing. The referee also speaks Thai, so it's going to be a big advantage to really run a clean fight here.
Stinging low kick by Sitmunchai, but it's Varga who's moving forward. He's trying to keep Sitmunchai up against the ropes. Lands a left hook. Spinning kick missed the mark, though, from Varga. High kick from Sitmunchai. We already are seeing a quicker pace by Sitmunchai than we saw in his debut, that's for sure. Under a minute to go in round number 1. Spinning high kick from Varga. Now he's got Sitmunchai stuck in the corner. Body shot from Varga. Counter from Sitmunchai.
Sitmunchai's camp is known for that. They let people come into them and they look for that big right hand and hook. So you saw Sitmunchai, there it is. He's trying to come back with that big power shot.
Body shot from Varga goes up top now. Knee from Sitmunchai, but not much on it. Flying knee from Gabriel Varga. Looked good, but didn't land. Spinning back fist just misses from Sitmunchai.
That's nice to see from the TIE fighters. That's normally not in their arsenal. Nice move.
Great action. Let's go back to Luke Thomas and the Gold Bond powder spray locker cam.
All right, I'm backstage here in the locker room of Mirko Krokop, who takes on Jarrell Miller in the main event of our Glory 17 Spike TV card. This fight is interesting for two reasons. One, it's the U.S. kickboxing debut of Mirko Krokop, but two, it's a rematch. They first fought in 2013. Mirko won, but Miller believes it was unfair. This is about to settle the differences, and he's been verbally assaulting Mirko this whole week, but Mirko has ignored it, took it all in stride, and believes that Miller has been disrespectful to the sport. It'll be interesting to see how that antagonism plays itself out in tonight's main event. Guys, back to you.
Thank you, Luke. He's not kidding. Boy, Jarrell Miller has brought that boxing attitude to kickboxing. He's talked all week long.
Seconds out. Seconds out. Mop hit. Thank you. Seconds out. Mop hit. Time.
What's going on there is in Thailand they wear a prajit. There's usually a charm, and that's blessed by a Buddhist monk, and they wear those for good luck for you fans at home.
Great insight. Round number two between Yokupon Sitmunchai in the white gloves and Gabriel Varga. This is semifinal number one of the Featherweight Contender Tournament. Very entertaining first round, Duke. Who'd you give it to?
Varga by activity. Again, good low kick there from Sitmunchai.
Well, we saw in his debut, Sitmunchai really picked up the pace in the second and third rounds, got more comfortable. We'll see if he can do that again tonight. Low kick delivered from Sitmunchai.
You can see even the
big push from Varga.
You can see the demeanor in his face. He's even changing. They call that in Thai, Chai Dam, the black heart. He's ready to fight. Nice right hand, though.
Right hand from Varga got through, and then it goes to the body. The fighters exchange. Question with Sitmunchai was, could he deal with the limited clinch? Here in Glory, no elbows, and that sometimes hampers ties. Uppercut from Sitmunchai got through.
Varga's doing a good job attacking, but he's got to be careful not staying in front of Sitmunchai, because he either gives up that low kick or Sitmunchai has that counter right he likes.
Approaching the midpoint of this fight. Scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds. And nice combination from Sitmunchai, and Varga tosses him to the ground. That does not count as a knockdown. Sitmunchai's corner begging him to push the pace, wanting him to pick it up. Uppercut from Sitmunchai. The fighters exchange again. That left high kick from Varga gets through. Follows it up with a knee.
The workman pace of Varga is what's doing it right now. Nice little tricky rainbow kick there.
Under a minute to go. Sitmunchai caught that kick. You can hold it, but then you have to immediately make a move, correct?
Yeah, you can hold it, you gotta drop it and strike. You can use it to set up a strike.
Combination from Varga, and now some blood streaming out of the nose of Yokupon Sitmunchai. Under 30 to go in round number two. Jab from Varga follows up with a straight kick to the face. Sitmunchai on the canvas, but is not ruled a knockdown. 10 seconds to go. Gabriel Varga looking very comfortable in this one as Sitmunchai retaliates as this fight, this round comes to an end.
Narrows that hook and cross that Sitmunchai's been trying to set up.
10 p.m. tonight, Eastern Time, last man standing. Eight men will battle it out, but only one will be crowned champion. What an incredible middleweight tournament that will be. We take a look at the second round highlights, Duke.
Yeah, and here he set up that nice little crispy overhand right. Tapped the double jab, changed the pace, and cracked him with the cross. There's Kru Dom, one of the best Muay Thai trainers in all of Thailand, trying to urge on his fighter. He wants him to go. He knows it's the last round, needs to work hard.
Seconds out. Mop his in.
Third and final round, semi-final number one, Gabriel Varga and Yodkumpan Sitmanchai. The winner will move on to the championship fight. And it's always interesting, the longer these fights go, will that be a factor in the championship fight? See some bad bruises on the thigh of Gabriel Varga, the left leg, and Sitmanchai continues to chop at it.
For you fans at home, that's nothing nice. Imagine someone swinging a baseball bat as hard as they can at you. That's what it's like getting caught with that shin kick.
Varga keeps going back to that spinning back fist. He hasn't had a lot of success with it, but it keeps breaking things up and keeping Sitmanchai at bay.
Exactly. That's why he's doing it. Those different moves are going to keep the technical Thai fighter, like Sitmanchai, a little off guard and won't let him get his game going.
The jab's now landing for Gabriel Varga. Check out the total strikes for this first round fight.
Well, the percentages are in Sitmanchai's favor, but the volume has been, as we see here, Varga, he's really putting it out there.
29-year-old Gabriel Varga came in with a 23-2 record. He was the favorite to win this featherweight contender tournament.
He had a great performance at Glory in Chicago against Jose Palacios. Nice liver shot and dropped his opponent and did a lot of great things in that fight.
High kick from Varga. Kickboxing and karate specialist, a real high-paced fighter. And he brings some knockout power too, pushing Sitmanchai back up against the ropes.
That's what you have to do against someone like Sitmanchai, who likes to throw bombs. You actually have to use your offense as defense. By keeping them defensive, it keeps them from hitting you hard.
Under a minute to go, semifinal number one.
That was a beautiful jumping switch kick. I was just talking on the Joe Rogan podcast the other day about that kick with Joe.
Joe will be in the house tonight.
Yeah, he's a huge fan of Glory, man. We had a great Joe Rogan podcast, and he loves Glory. We were talking a lot of fun stuff.
30 seconds to go, round three. Controlled by Gabriel Varga, the Canadian. The number five ranked featherweight in Glory. And again, it seems that Sitmanchai still just hasn't adapted to those kickboxing rules yet. A little hesitant and not much offense as Gabriel Varga finishes strong. That's going to do it for this semifinal number one between Varga and Sitmanchai. Glory 17 rolls on.
I tell you, Ron, Yodkumpun showed some moments of greatness in that fight. That last combo he let rip was beautiful. He's 19 years old. He shows a lot of potential. And I think he's going to bring more of his countrymen from Thailand into the sport of kickboxing. He just needs more time to get back to the gym and develop. I think Varga won that decision. He did what he had to do. He pot-shot him, picked him apart. And I think he's punched his ticket to the final.
Well, Sitmanchai is a very athletic and entertaining fighter. It's a 61% knockout ratio. 51 of his 83 victories coming by way of knockout. So we take a look at some of the highlights, Duke.
Here, look at this. Here's that uppercut. He countered the liver, his hook, right hand over the top. That's vintage Sit Munchai. And he was going for it at the end. And, you know, again, this is such a deep division. Featherweight is such a deep division. All these guys are athletic, skilled, and cagey. So they're going to fight each other again. They're both young. And we're going to see more classic battles between these two guys in the glory ring again.
Gabriel Varga, raised in a household of martial arts. His dad is a karate instructor. Began teaching him at the age of 5. By his late teens, unbelievable, he was already a second-degree black belt.
I can relate. That's how I grew up, growing up in the martial arts, and that's how these kids are coming into the sport these days. Even later on the pay-per-view, Rico Verhoeven started as a child in martial arts, and it's such a great sport and discipline for children these days to get involved with martial arts. My life got saved through martial arts, and I'm here with you today because of it.
Well, we're glad you are, and you hear that story a lot, that the martial arts has really saved kids who are maybe troubled youth or just looking for discipline in their lives. Varga, the former ISKA amateur world light welterweight champion, and Yodkapon Sitmunchai might have to go back to the drawing board. But, you know, again, it's his second fight, still struggling with the glory kickboxing rules. We saw flashes from him, but just wasn't the complete fight.
Once he learns the sport, I think he's going to be a great asset to the division, to the fans, and he's going to be a big name. It's just going to take time.
He's an avid Manchester U fan. He's also completing his degree in accounting. Seemed very focused, but Gabriel Varga, 29-year-old, just really put on a clinic, I think, in this fight. Very experienced. We will make it official. Here is the judges. Tally their scorecards. Welcome back to Glory 17 Los Angeles as we check out the final stats.
Again, the main stat was the percentage landed and the volume of Varga, and that's what won this fight for him, I believe.
Really all Varga in this one. Tonight's highlights are brought to you by 300 Rise of an Empire. Own the Blu-ray this Tuesday. Digital HD available now.
Nice overhand right, precision striking with his hands. Varga was very accurate there. That sneaky uppercut went back to the body. And again, he did the old school combo called the Four Horsemen. Body head, body head. Nice work.
Let's make it official and go back into the glory ring and Tim Hughes.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we send it to the judges' scorecard. And they give us back a unanimous decision. All three judges score the bout the same, 30-27. For your winner, who now advances to the tournament final, Gabriel Varga!
So Gabriel Varga has punched his ticket into the featherweight contender finals. He'll return to the locker room to wait and find out who his opponent later tonight will be. And that opponent will be either one of these two men in the second semifinal of the contender tournament, either California's Shane Oblonsky or Brazil's Marcus Vinicius. Semifinal number two coming up. Introduce our fights. Here's Tim Hughes.
Two hungry young fighters fell out the other half of the bracket. From the Bahia region of Brazil and the streets of SoCal, Marcus Vinicius and Shane